Hello, welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Francis Emukule, your host for today. Now, I always say that innovation should be driven to drive comfort, solve solution, and put people to a better standard of living. And as I speak to you right now, smart toilets have been a big talk in Uganda sometimes, but mostly in Europe. But today I'm excited to tell you that I am seated on one. And I'm excited to take you along this journey, just to introduce you and give you the nitty-gritties of what it means to have a smart toilet in your house, or what it takes for you to use a smart toilet. This gentleman right here is going to be taking us through what it means to have a smart toilet in your home. For me, I feel like I've already arrived in heaven, using a smart toilet, because it has several user experience, buttons, that we'll be getting into later on. Speak to me, what's your name?
My name is Mwemba Tony, and I'm from 6th Street Industrial Area. I work with a company known as Ujia International Limited. Actually, we deal in plumbing materials. We also have the sanitary ware. That's where you actually come out with the issue of the smart toilets. So actually, the smart toilets is a new innovation in technology, the water technology. You know, way back, actually, like the other modes of sanitary ware, like where we used to have the ceramic toilets. But right now, it's a new life technology that China has actually bought to lead. And this is what I want to actually expose to the world.
Okay. Yes. So earlier on, before we came on set, you told me this toilet is different from this one. So please, let's start with this one. This particular one. So what's the difference?
Actually the difference between this toilet and the one that I'm sitting on,
just talk to me about this.
This toilet that everyone is seeing on the screen, this one is called a Type A advanced toilet. Actually, about this toilet, everything does on its own. It is an automatic toilet. You don't have to do anything on this toilet. Even if the cleansing, everything, you just have to wait and see what is going to happen. First of all, this is how it works. So when it's actually installed, maybe in your house, so the first step before using it is you have to press this button downwards with your feet. You don't have to press it with your hands, just like I'm actually exhibiting right now, but you have to press it with your feet here. Then exactly when you're done with that, it's going to automatically open up this seat cover. So after when it's done with the opening of the seat cover, then you're going to sit here. So after sitting here, like, the attribute that makes it special is that it is going to sense your presence exactly when you're sitting.
It has a motion sensor or a bump sensor?
Sensors on the seat here. So after when you're seated, then it's going to sense your presence. Then after sensing your presence, it is going to generate temperature that are like moderate temperatures that are going to make everything very, very okay with you. And then that is also for another benefit of actually being antibacterial, antimicroscopic. So it can also be used for an extended family. There is no any kind of things like, you're going to contact diseases. No, for this toilet, it is.
So the heat is more like it neutralizes the environment to make it clean.
Yeah, it also neutralizes the environment and also making it very okay for every usage. When you sit here and like you feel like all like what you're going to do, like it has to be done in a moderate climate. like the temperatures have to be very, very.
What temperatures does it set itself to?
Actually, it regulates temperatures to about even 97 degrees Celsius. So you might feel like maybe it's a cold temperature, or maybe the weather outside is very cold, but you feel like you don't want to experience the coldness. So for that resolution, then you're going to actually adjust the temperature.
Make it warmer.
Yeah, to make it warmer, because it also has the button where you can regulate manually if you don't want an automatic regulation. It has the plus button. Yeah, we have the plus button and the minus button. The plus button is to increase on the temperature levels, then the minus button is to decrease on the temperature levels. Yeah. Then
what else does it do?
After when you're done with the biological rows, actually you have to flush. Then this is how it flushes. So after when you're done with the natural rows, then you're going to press this button where you see flash.
Oh, flash, yes.
So after pressing that button of a flash, so it's going to actually do two things at once. The first thing is going to cleanse you automatically. How? It has this kind of hole that you're seeing here. It is the entrance for what they call a shutoff. There is a pipe that is going to get out of this and is going to cleanse you downwards, as well as actually drying you at the same time. You understand what I'm talking about? So after when that is done, it's going to do what they call a deep flushing. So it's going to flush itself entirely, then it's going to close its seat cover automatically without your contribution. So though some people might not find it actually very convenient for this kind of shutoff to cleanse you, you can as well use the manual way. So what is the manual way while using a smart toilet? So after when you're done with the things, then you actually get off, you stand up, then you cleanse yourself in the manual way. Then after that, you press the what? The button. It only brings out the shutoff when it has sensed your presence. You get what I'm talking about?
So that means when you're done and you've cleaned yourself, you can flush manually? Okay.
But if you want the automatic experience, the technological experience, that's when you actually feel like you have to feel everything. Yeah, that's why you have to actually use it for its specific role.
Okay. Now, the other question is, you said this thing is electric, it's powered by electricity, all right? So what if I sit and I get shocked?
Actually, that can't be possible for any reason. Reason being, this toilet was designed with all those cautions. First of all, the wire, like the connection wires of this toilet, they are placed or installed on the wall. And also, the ceramic, it is not actually a conductivity of current.
So it's plastic?
No, it is actually made from clay. Okay. You understand? So with that kind of design, we don't expect any kind of electric interference with us. Then when actually it gets maybe kind of sorted, maybe it has shocked things of maintenance, mm-hmm. It can easily be maintained through the usual ways as other toilets are maintained. For example, if it gets a problem on the wire, actually you have to use the normal electricians. The usual electricians can sort out.
So the wiring system is not so complicated.
It's not so complicated as most of the people might think. As well as if it's about the plumbing system, as well you can use the normal plumbers. You understand what I'm talking about?
So what? Talk to me about the two types of plumbing that can be used here. Earlier on, when you're having a conversation, you told me there is one whereby the pipe does not have to that takes the residues.
Actually, all the toilets, not only these toilets, they have two plumbing systems. We have the P plumbing system and the S plumbing system. So the P plumbing system, it means that all the connectivity is going to be placed on the wall.
I know that.
Whereas the S is going, like all the connectivities are going to be downwards in the sewage system.
So which one is the best for this one?
The best actually connection system, it has to be a strap for these toilets.
Strap?
Yeah, all these toilets are S-trap. They are connected downwards for simplicity. You understand my point? Because also, like, why these toilets mostly are designed in this kind of trap, first of all, the way they were designed, they don't fit for being connected on the wall.
S-trap.
Yeah, they are all S-trap for that actually reason. Yeah. Then, it actually has two modes of keeping power. It can generate power while it's in, actually,
plugged in.
Yeah, when it's plugged in the power source. Then it can also actually use the power that is stored on the battery, so
and save its own battery. In other words, it can charge when not in use.
Yeah, definitely, it can charge while not in use, and actually that can go for 7 days. It has the capacity of actually maintaining and containing that power for 7 days. So even if the power is away, or maybe off, or maybe you have power issues, so you can still use these toilets for 7 days. Yeah.
So you talked about temperature regulation.
Yes, sir.
And I'm a man, you know. So what if the temperature is okay? It's very cold, and I want to a relatively hot environment while I do my business down there. What are the side effects that I might get roasted from under?
Okay, first of all, that might be a perception. Reason being, our body, like our.
What's the likelihood that I might get roasted from down?
Actually, there is nothing like a complication that you're going to face. Reason being,
no side effect.
No side effect. Reason being, you regulate the temperature. You can regulate the temperature that you feel that is comfortable with your body. For example, if you feel like you don't want too warm temperature, or maybe if you want a minimal temperature, that's what you have to set because of the other buttons of plus and minus. Yeah, so that's how you can actually do that. Then you've actually been talking about the temperature regulation. Temperature regulation is of a greater benefit as compared to the demerits. Reason being, it is also very it is very healthy. You understand? Like all these microbes, all the microscopic organisms are very are killed moreover sudden because of the temperatures, which is not like the other normal temperatures that you're seeing every day, the ceramic toilets that are not smart. Yeah, for them, you just have to clean them by yourself. But this one, it is unlike. For it, everything it does automatically. So that's why I actually prefer those people living in extended families. They have to actually use this toilet. Reason being, it is very safe, very convenient, and very easy to use. It is a wonderful experience to use the smart toilets. Yes, sir.
So, you know, using the normal ordinary toilet, yeah, it's believed that there's every time you flush, it's a lot of water that goes, yeah. So when you use that self-cleaning system, how much of water is used?
Yeah, actually, when you're using the cleaning system, like the quantities of water that are going to be used for the cleaning, it is not a great amount. You understand my point? Though, like, you might think about it in that kind of perspective that it's going to use
a lot of water,
which is not the case in this way. Because for this one, the water that is going to be actually, that is going to get out of the shutoff, it is minimal water. It is the water that is just very ideal for the cleansing, not excess water. Yeah, because if it was excess water, that's when you would have said it is not actually water preserving. Yeah.
It's very interesting. Now, there's this particular question that keeps lingering in my mind. How much does it cost?
Actually, this toilet is very cheap for the experience.
How much?
It costs 2 million Ugandan shillings for the retailers. Those people will come and they are going to purchase like one. But then for the wholesalers, they can as well purchase. If you reach the factor that you can actually purchase 3 of these toilets, then you qualify to be a wholesaler. In that way, you'll actually reduce on the costs. Yeah, so it is better off someone to like purchase these like 3 of them to actually reduce on the costs.
Why do you think I should buy a smart toilet?
Okay, you should buy a smart toilet. First of all, it is very convenient for all age brackets. So,
do you have one?
Yeah, of course. I'm planning to. Yeah, not yet there, but I'm planning to because this is a wonderful experience. You understand? I would prefer these toilets from the normal toilets. Reason being, first of all, they have a wonderful experience and very easy to use in a way that you don't need to use more of logic. Some people might find it very difficult to use it in that way, but it is very easy. Just pressing button per button, then everything is done. You just go and do your own stuff. So even if maybe you find yourself in a situation, maybe when you're out of time, but you want to fast pee, or you want to fast maybe make a long call, then you can definitely use the shortest time. You understand my point?
You pee and then let it fly.
Then you leave everything for it to handle.
Is there a specific procedure that I need to follow when maintaining this toilet? What am I supposed to do and what am I not supposed to do?
Okay, these are the do's and don'ts. First of all, when you find yourself possessing such a toilet in your house, first of all, you have to understand like the type of product that you've actually purchased. First of all, these toilets, they are ceramic toilets as well as electrified, which means they are like two things coated on something one. You understand? So which means you have to as well observe the like you have to observe the procedures of maintaining the ceramic as well as the procedure of maintaining a good electric system. You understand? Then for the electric system, I would say that you have to actually vast yourself with the quantity of current that you're using. Correct? Yeah.
How is that?
Way, I mean, like for the guys maybe using your car, that might be very okay. But there are guys who are using electricity that is not regulated. You understand? Those are who are using maybe they call it bypassed electric. Bypassed electric might be actually a disaster on these kinds of toilets. Reason being, it might actually bring about that kind of variations in the current that is entering and the current that is being regulated. So for that reason, you might find that maybe when you're facing a challenge in the electric system. So the electric system can also make variations in the water system, because it's the electric system that is governing the water system. How? So when you get a faulty in the electric system, meaning you are going to face issues like the pressure, flushing pressure might be minimal for the pressure that it had at first. You understand my point? Then the other thing, you might find that it might actually change its routines. Instead of giving you temperature, you might find it when it's actually flashing without even you commanding.
Malfunction.
But just know, it is very easy to service. The only thing that you have to do, you have to first know what kind of problem. Because if you get to know the problem, that's when you're going to use the right system or the right procedure to end it. You understand my point? If it's about the electric system, how can you find out that it's the electric system that has a problem?
How do you find out?
First of all, the flushing pressure is going to reduce. You might think maybe it's a plumbing, but it might be an electric. Because when the electric current is not passing passing through the wires in the right way, then you might find it like the pressure is going to reduce and the routines are going to be slowed. You understand my point? So that's when you realize that you need an electrician to sort out that. Then if it's about the plumbing, you can find maybe the leakages. You find it maybe leaking areas where you've never you never expected. So that's when you might think about the plumbing procedure. Yeah, but anyway, this I could actually say that these toilets are wonderful toilets in a way that even if you actually have a visitor maybe at home, when he actually enters your bathroom, then he gets this kind of wonderful experience. Like, there is a way you become classy. There is a way to promote, like, I don't know what to say, but the way he's going to take you,
you're the marketing spirit.
Prayed. You understand my point?
Yeah,
because you know it is not common. That's why.
It is not.
We want these toilets to vast the market, but they are very good, very wonderful.
Okay.
So this is called the new life. Yeah. So this is the
A-mod. This is the A-mod.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also have the mod B,
which one is mod B?
This one that I'm sitting on right now. It is.
What's the difference?
Mod B, specifically mod B. Actually, for it is not electrified. It does not use electricity, though it has a battery that is chargeable and is movable, which means you have to only charge the battery. You don't have to charge the entire toilet, just like mod A. So for this case, after charging your battery, you have to plug in the toilet, and then it's going to start its function. You understand my point? Then another difference between the two brands is mod B like does not do the individual cleansing. It's like the normal toilet. You can carry your own cleansing tissue, maybe the toilet paper, but for A it is not necessary, unlike otherwise if you want to use it. Yeah, but this one, yeah, this battery, it can go as far as 7 days.
This small battery,
it can keep energy that is going to make actually this function for 7 days. All our things have the capacity to actually contain power for 7 days.
7 days. So what are the maintenance routines?
Actually, the maintenance routines, like, they are not going to change much.
Same.
It's the same. The way you actually maintain your ceramic toilet at home, your ceramic sink.
How do you maintain ceramic?
Okay, ceramic, it is actually, you have to regularly clean it with water that is actually mixed with detergent. But for type A, it won't be necessary. Reason being, it has its own cleaning routine. Internal cleaning routine, except if you want to dust it outside, maybe if it actually contains dust, that's when you have to actually clean it outside. But internal cleansing, you don't have to do that. It is necessary, it is not necessary. You understand my point? Then for this one, you can just do the normal routine of maintaining ceramic. Yeah,
that's all.
Yeah, then what I don't want to leave out is that our quality, this is the A brand. It is actually the finest tested brand that has arrived on market. First of all, this ceramic that we actually hold, it was tested and it was molded more than 5 times to bring out this quality. So you might find similar products on the market, but the quality is different. So
okay.
The quality is beyond. So it is like a tasty sample. So we had to bring these few samples to test whether it is going to work out in the market. It is very cheap. These are all cheaper toilets. We don't have anything like an expensive toilet because we want this technology to get vast in the world. So for us, we have our objective for actually being the number one distributor and supplier of ceramics in Africa.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
How much is this?
So this one, unlike this one is a bit lower from the what? From the total cost of this A. Yeah, this one costs only 590 Ugandan shillings.
I'm buying this one.
Only 590.
I'm buying.
Yeah.
It's quite affordable.
Yeah, it's quite affordable. That's why we actually had to bring A and B, just to make sure that everyone can actually get this. Yeah.
How has been the perception? How are you going to find it?
Actually, you know, we have a long time myth, a long time perception that has been actually prevailing all these years about China products. But unlike us, because for us we know about this quality because we know the product knowledge, unlike anyone who can just come or all of a sudden and just criticize. Actually, our products were fine, like they were tested several times to qualify for the market for customer satisfaction. Yeah, unlike any other Chinese stuff, but for us, our stuff is actually the finest. Yeah, it's not kind of persuading what I'm having, because I know there are also similar products on the market, but I know what I'm talking about, because we can test even the ceramic, we can test even the electric system, everything very okay. But we do not only have the toilets, but we have got different products concerning sanitary and the plumbing. Yeah, we have the hand wash basins, we have the bathroom cabinets, as they can see backwards. Yeah, we have that one comes in a full set with a mirror, it has a lighting system, very good. We have in different sizes, the small sizes for those with minimal space, you can as well come and actually gain this. Like, why do you have to buy a bathroom cabinet of 800,000 shillings, yet you have a space not even 2 square meters, yet you can buy something of 198,000 that fits in your space? So that's also something that is actually not being understood well by the people.
Working within your space. All right, thank you so much. It's a pleasure doing business with you.
It's a privilege as well, being hosted on your show. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Pleasure is mine. What I take away from this conversation is comfort. Technology is here to simplify life, but also to make our life simple. If you're out there and you're looking for a smart toilet and you're looking to upgrade your life, please look no further than, you know, starting from your toilet, because that is very key. A lot of ideas are born in the toilet, and many of them that have been born in the toilet have been born from comfortable toilets. At least from my experience, many of the beautiful ideas I've put in place and executed, I thought about them while seated on a toilet with my phone. My name is Francis Emukule. I hope that has been an informative show for you. Please make it a date to catch us again next time here on Urban TV on the Homes and Construction Show. See you next time.